In circle and circumcircle of a triangle. Let us see how to construct the incircle of a triangle. But before that, let us see the discussion of what is in the incenter and circumcenter of a triangle. First, let us see what is the incenter of the triangle. And then we can see what is called the incircle of the triangle. Incenter is the point of concurrence of all the angle bisectors of a triangle. The circle which touches all the sides of a triangle is called incircle of the triangle. And the center of the circle is called the incenter of the triangle. Incenter is the point of concurrence of all the angle bisectors of a triangle. Incenter is denoted by the letter I. Now we can see an example in page number 83 in your textbook. Construct triangle PQR such that PQ is equal to 6 cm. Measure of angle Q is equal to 35 degrees. First you have to draw the rough figure. You can see page number 83 in your textbook. Then you have to construct the fair figure. Construct triangle PQR such that PQ is equal to 6 cm and take measure of angle Q as 35 degrees. You have to take measure of QRS, that is length of QRS 5.5 cm. Make triangle PQR. So in your textbook you have a problem. You can open page number 83 and see the construction. Construct triangle PQR such that PQ is equal to 6 cm. Measure of angle Q is equal to 35 degrees. QR is equal to 5.5 cm. Draw incircle of triangle PQR. So at first you have to draw a rough figure and show all the measures in it. Then construct triangle PQR of the given measures. Draw the angle bisectors of any two angles. It is enough to draw the angle bisector of any two angles of the triangle. Denote the point of intersection of angle bisectors as I. Draw perpendicular IM from the point I to the side PQ. It is better if you use the pair of compass for that, to draw the perpendicular from I. So draw the perpendicular IM from the point I to the side PQ. Draw a circle with center I and radius IM. The required circle will be the incircle of triangle PQR. Now, let us see the construction of circumcircle. First, let us see what is called circumcircle of the triangle and what is called the circumcenter of the triangle. The circle passing through all the vertices of a triangle is called circumcircle of the triangle, and the center of the circle is called the circumcenter of the triangle. Circumcenter is the point of concurrence of all the perpendicular bisectors of sides of the triangle. Listen carefully. Circumcenter is the point of concurrence of all the perpendicular bisectors of sides of the triangle. Circumcenter is denoted by the letter C. Let us construct triangle DEF such that DE is equal to 4.2 cm. Angle D is equal to 60 degrees. Angle E is equal to 70 degrees. And draw example of it. Draw a rough figure, write the given measures. Take page number 84 and see how the rough figure is drawn there. Then draw triangle DEF of the given measures, that is DE is equal to 4.2 cm. Measure of angle D is equal to 60 degrees. Measure of angle E is equal to 70 degrees. You all know how to construct a triangle. So first of all, construct triangle DEF. Then draw perpendicular bisectors of any two sides of the triangle. You have to draw the perpendicular bisectors of any two sides of a triangle. I have taught you how to draw the perpendicular bisectors when I taught you the construction in the previous lessons. So you are able to do the perpendicular bisectors. So draw perpendicular bisectors of any two sides of the triangle. It is enough to draw for any two sides of the triangle. Name the point of intersection of the perpendicular bisectors as C, because we are naming the circumcenter as C. Now join segment CF. Draw circle with center C and radius CF. The required circle will be the circumcircle of the triangle, of the given triangle DEF. Now coming to page number 85, you have an activity. Draw different triangles of different measures and draw in circles and circumcircles of them. Complete the table of observations and discuss. Here a table is given and some boxes are given. You have to fill in the boxes. Type of triangle: equilateral triangle, isosceles triangle, scalene triangle, acute angle triangle, right angle triangle and obtuse angle triangle. Position of in center for equilateral triangle is, if you draw the, you have to draw and see. You have to draw and see, then only you can understand. Draw an equilateral triangle, draw the circumcenter and the in center. That means you have to draw the circumcircle and the in circle. Then you will understand the position of in center. So then you have to write this, fill in the boxes. You have to draw an equilateral triangle and check. Then isosceles triangle, scalene triangle, acute angle triangle, right angle triangle and an obtuse angle triangle. You have to draw the in circle and circumcircle of them and check the position of in center and position of circumcenter. Then only you can fill in these boxes. Now listen, finally you will get such a result. Position of in center for equilateral triangle will be inside the triangle. For an isosceles triangle it will be inside the triangle. For the scalene triangle it will be inside the triangle. For an acute angle triangle it will be inside the triangle. For a right angle triangle it will be inside the triangle. For an obtuse angle triangle it will be inside the triangle. Now coming to position of circumcenter. For an equilateral triangle it will be inside the triangle. For an isosceles triangle it can be inside, outside or on the triangle. For a scalene triangle it can be inside the triangle, outside the triangle or on the triangle. For an acute angle triangle it can be inside the triangle, it will be inside the triangle. Right, for a right angle triangle it will be the midpoint of the hypotenuse. Position of circumcenter will be the midpoint of the hypotenuse. For an obtuse angle triangle, position of circumcenter will be outside the triangle. Now you have to remember all these. In circle of a triangle touches all sides of the triangle from inside. For construction of in circle of a triangle, we have to draw angle bisectors of any two angles of the triangle. Circumcircle of a triangle passes through all the vertices of a triangle. For construction of a circumcircle of a triangle, we have to draw perpendicular bisectors of any two sides of the triangle. Circumcenter of an acute angle triangle lies inside the triangle. center of a right angle triangle is the midpoint of its hypotenuse. Circumcenter of an obtuse angle triangle lies in the exterior of the triangle. Incenter of any triangle lies in the interior of the triangle. Now coming to an activity, you can do this and see. Draw any equilateral triangle. Draw incircle and circumcircle of it. What do you observe while doing this activity? While drawing incircle and circumcircle, do the angle bisectors and perpendicular bisectors coincide with each other? Do the incenter and circumcenter coincide with each other? If so, what can be the reason of it? Measure the radius of incircle and circumcircle and write their ratio. Now, the answers to these will be, for the first one, the perpendicular bisectors and angle bisectors of an equilateral triangle are coincident. For the second question, the answer will be, the incenter and the circumcenter of an equilateral triangle are coincident. For the third one, measure the radius of incircle and circumcircle and write their ratio. After measuring the radius of incircle and circumcircle, you can find out that ratio of radius of circumcircle to the radius of incircle of an equilateral triangle is 2:1. You can see the answer in page number 86 under remember this. Now coming to practice set 6.3. Question number 1. Construct triangle ABC such that measure of angle B is equal to 100 degrees, BC is equal to 6.4 centimeters, measure of angle C is equal to 50 degrees and construct its incircle. Draw the rough figure. I have not shown it. You have to draw it. Draw BC of 6.4 centimeters. Draw measure of angle B is equal to 100 degrees. So the ray BA has to be drawn in such a way that measure of angle B is equal to 100 degrees. Take measure of angle C is equal to 50 degrees using the protractor. Here the marking is wrong. Instead of A, mark C in the base. Angle C is only equal to 50 degrees. So change that A in the base as C and take the measure as 50 degrees. Where the rays YB and XC meet, name the point as A. Triangle ABC is thus obtained. Now construct the angle bisectors of angle B and angle C and let them meet at point O. You know how to draw the angle bisectors. For angle B, keep the protractor, one end of the protractor at B and draw an arc. Draw a big arc. Then it meets AB at one point and also BA at one point. CB at one point and BA at one point. Take more than half of the distance and draw arcs. Keep it on the other side and cut the first arc. So now you will get a ray. Similarly, for angle C, keep at the vertex C the compass and do similarly, construct one angle bisector. That will be ray CO. So ray BO and ray CO meet at the point O. So construct the angle bisectors of angle B and angle C and let them meet at point O. Through point O, draw a perpendicular to line BC. You know how to draw the perpendicular? It is not perpendicular bisector, it is a perpendicular. Keep one end of the compass at O and make an arc downwards on the base CB. Then you get two points over there. Take more than half of the distance and draw arcs. Make one arc and keep it at the other point and make the other arc. So you can join O and that particular point of intersection. Then you will get ray OP. Mark the right angle there, it is not shown. OP is perpendicular to CB, so mark that right angle over there. Now with O as center and OP as radius, draw a circle inside the triangle ABC. This is the required in circle. Now coming to question number 2. Construct triangle PQR such that measure of angle P is equal to 70 degrees, measure of angle R is equal to 50 degrees, QR is equal to 7.3 centimeters, and construct its circumcircle. Now, in order to construct the circumcircle, here the base is QR, but you are getting only the measure of angle R, we are not getting measure of angle Q. We want the base angles compulsory to construct the triangle. So using the given values of measure of angle P and measure of angle R, you have to find out measure of angle Q by angle sum property of triangles. Sum of the measures of all the angles in a triangle is 180 degrees. Therefore, measure of angle P plus measure of angle Q plus measure of angle R is equal to 180 degrees. Substitute all the known values and find out the measure of Q. You will get it to be 60 degrees. Now draw line segment QR such that its length is 7.3 centimeters. With QR center, draw an angle of 60 degrees using the protractor. Similarly, draw an angle of 50 degrees with R as center. Where the rays RY and XQ meet, name the point as P. Thus, we are drawing triangle PQR. First, you have to construct triangle PQR. Then, draw the perpendicular bisectors of sides PR and QR. Of sides PR and QR, you have to draw the perpendicular bisectors. Let these perpendicular bisectors meet at point O. With O as center and OP as radius, construct a circle touching all the vertices of the triangle PQR. This circle is the required circumcircle. Now coming to question number 3. Constructing the incircle, I have already taught you, so you can do it. First, you have to construct the triangle. Then you have to construct the angle bisectors of any two angles. Here we have constructed for angle X and angle Z, the angle bisectors. And let them meet at point O. Through point O, draw a perpendicular to line XZ. Let the perpendicular meet the line XZ at point P. With O as center and OP as radius, draw a circle inside the triangle XYZ. This is the required in circle. Now coming to question number 4. In triangle LMN, LM is equal to 7.2 centimeters. Measure of angle M is equal to 105 degrees. MN is equal to 6.4 centimeters. Then draw triangle LMN and construct its circumcircle. Whenever you do the perpendicular bisectors or in any other rays or something, you have to put arrowheads. Here the arrowheads are very tiny to see. So So it is looking as if no arrowheads are there for the perpendicular bisectors. Please do it. So you know how to construct a circumcircle, I have taught you. First you construct the triangle. Then draw perpendicular bisectors of any two sides. Here of NM and LM, the perpendicular bisectors are drawn. These perpendicular bisectors meet at point O. With O as center and OM as radius, construct a circle touching all the vertices of triangle LM. This circle is the required circumcircle. Now coming to question number 5. First of all, construct triangle DEF. DE is equal to EF is equal to 6 cm is given. Measure of angle F is equal to 45 degrees. First construct triangle DEF. Then because we have to construct its circumcircle, draw the perpendicular bisectors of the lines, that means of the sides DF and EF. You have to draw for any two sides, it's enough. So draw the perpendicular bisectors of the sides DF and EF. Let these perpendicular bisectors meet at point O. With O as center and OE as radius, construct a circle touching all the vertices of triangle DF. This circle is thus the required circumcircle.